So, I'm at the airport here and I saw this sign. Remember to register your ATA. And then in Cyrillic language it says Actual Time of Arrival. I thought that was amusing. Actual Time of Arrival. So guys, I'm at a place I've wanted to visit for a while and I'm hoping today we'll gain access. And it's the old Riga Airport. It was actually built in 1954 and it was operational up until 1975, the year I was born. So it's been out of business now for about 47 years. And the thing is, they've built a lot of these around the Soviet Union, but this particular one, it's still intact. It's still in its original, well, the interior's just not been done up at all. So as it was is how it is. I don't know if you can see up there. Over there, the old Soviet sickle and hammer, the symbol of the Soviet Union. All the windows here, although some of them are in bad state. And you have to understand, this place is what? 54, 72 years old, I guess. Might be wrong. But the windows, you see that there's a sickle and hammer. Then wing and propeller, and this is history. Now, it's not impressive compared to some of the airports today, but once upon a time, this would have been really impressive. And to me, I find it impressive, the history side of it. So let's walk around, because I know the front's closed. They said to me, round the back, there might be a guy that's in charge of restoring it to its original, well, just, you know, making it look right. And apparently, he's an artist, and he should be here somewhere.
Yeah, у нас просто почему спрашивают?
Сергей. Здравствуйте. У меня есть YouTube канал.
Да.
И это здание, конечно, очень интересное для меня.
Это главный аэропорт города Риги был.
Да.
С 54-го года.
И как я понимаю, там ничего не сделали, это все оригинальное внутри, там очень мало.
Ну,
там
очистили моего, я просто реставрацию занимаюсь его.
А, вы сделаете реставрацию, да?
Да, да. Это в оригинале, да, здесь было много, убирали лишнего, которое было сделано. А так это да. Это основной аэродром города Риги 54-го года.
So this was built in 1954, and Sergei here is in charge of the airport. He's also an artist. I saw him painting over there in the
Вы художник тоже, да?
Look at this, guys. Wow! Look at this ceiling. This is all original. Built in 1954, as many airports that were built during the Soviet times, but I think this is the only one still left in its original form. It hasn't been touched at all. You can see the painting up there of basically what seems like a celebration with the Soviet flag, the Latvian Soviet flag, and a plane above, and the stars. This is magnificent, guys.
Вот это самая уникальная фреска, которую все приезжают смотреть. Видите, все одеты в латышские национальные костюмы, все одеты.
Да.
И только одна фигура вот с рукой вот так. Одета в русское платье с кокошником на голове. Это кокошник называется.
Да.
По первоначальным эскизам это был товарищ Сталин. И он назывался товарищ Сталин, призывает латвийский народ вступать в тесную дружную семью с СССР. В 54-му году Сталин умирает, и начинается борьба с культом личности Сталина. Его переделали. И поэтому получилась вот такая женщина с таким жестом руки.
Ага.
Ну, сталинским. И все внимание к ней. И она только одна единственная, одета в русское платье.
Да. Как интересно все это. И как, когда закрывали этот аэропорт?
Он был основным аэропортом города Риги с 54 по 75 год. Это все самолеты прилетали сюда. Только один существовал. С 75-го открывается новый аэропорт. И поэтому он стал вспомогательным. Здесь учебный центр был, обучали пилотов, плюс сельскохозяйственные, там вспомогательная авиация была, малая авиация. Сейчас вот здесь проводим единственные, ну, выставки, фильмы снимаем.
Фильмы снимают здесь, да?
Да, 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 очень много
типа
фильмов.
Типа как сет, да, для...
Сейчас к клип снимали последний, это клип Лего. Лего, конструктор Лего, у них юбилейный, 90 лет снимали здесь.
Снимали здесь, да?
Да, а вот эта выставка, вот это я делаю выставку раз в год. Происходит выставка, тут музыканты играют и все.
So once a year he holds a fair, and I'll put the Instagram and YouTube page right under here. But once a year they hold a fair here. And it looks pretty cool, and there's musicians, and I'm assuming food, hopefully there's food. And I noticed over here there's more paintings. I mean, this is surreal, guys. I'm in a Soviet airport. Sigulda. Sigulda, это. So this is the town of Sigulda, we've been there. Unbelievable, I'm in a Soviet airport, guys, these don't exist anymore. And up there is the town of Sigulda. If you remember in my video where we walked up all the stairs. Oh, my legs are burning! And I was cursing. Oh, fuck me, there's more? And look at these features. I mean, things are not made like this anymore, guys. Things are just not made like this anymore. Ah, it's Jurmala. And on the other extreme over there, we have the city of Jurmala, which is the coastline of Riga. And I can't believe I'm in here. This is just amazing. Look at these pillars. These are all marble. I mean, in the 1950s, when they built stuff, they really built stuff. Look at this. So this was Wow. None of this has been repainted. Look, the ceiling over here. This is all original from 1954. And so is the floor. And I recognize these floors. You get this a lot. Typical Soviet parquet. This would have been the VIP waiting area. And the reason being, because right here, it's, I don't know if it's closed off. It looks like it's sealed off. But over there, obviously, we're just seeing the main hall. But over there, through there, was the restaurant. So the VIP, I guess, VIP in the Soviet Union would have meant politicians, famous people, actors, singers. They would have waited in this area, even though theoretically none of that was supposed to be happening and wasn't supposed to exist. But look at this. Absolutely amazing. And right here, if you see these pillars, and look up there, guys, till today, the sickle and hammer and the Soviet star and another sickle and hammer. Wow. And what I'm fearing, guys, is that all of this, all these details that I've just shared with you, one day will be torn down because they're trying to eradicate history, because a lot of people suffered during that era. Basically, a lot of people are trying to eliminate that part of history, which to me doesn't make much sense, but each to his own, I guess. And over there, if you notice, it says Bagajnaya, so that would have been the place where they would have kept the baggage. And that would have been the exit, Izea, Vihod, and Bagaja, which is basically baggage in Latvian. And that would have been no exit, so that would have been the entrance to the airport. And guys, Sergei, спасибо вам большое. Это для меня просто.
Так что приезжайте на выставку, участвуйте.
Это какое число будет?
18, там я вам покажу. Выставка, она открыта, это Art Fair. Все желающие. У нас приедут с Германии, с Голландии. Вы откуда?
Я из Англии.
С Англии приезжайте, будем рады вас видеть. Почему художники, скульпторы? Вот это афиша. Видите, Wings of Riga.
Wings of Riga?
Может,
это в август будет, да?
Да, это на дни празднования города Риги. Здесь является локация празднования города. Здесь очень много, здесь авиашоу.
100% буду. Это 3 дня будет.
Художники могут даже участвовать с Англии. Пожалуйста, пишут заявку и участвуют.
Да?
Да. Это Artfire, очень большое мероприятие, будет ретро-машин советских, будет там один день, будет и на улице локация, так здесь, и стрит-арт, и внутри.
Супер.
Так что, да.
Творческих, Сергей,
творческих успехов.
Спасибо большое, спасибо большое. So guys, this was an amazing moment. I've been wanting to see this place for a while, and as I said, it's living history. Just look at the top over there. I don't know if you can see, but it still says Riga in Russian, and that is very unusual. Now we're looking at the back end of the building, and if you look up here, you can see it clearly now, because at the front it says, there's the Soviet symbol up there, and it says Latvia PSR, which is the Latvian Soviet Republic. And on the 18th to the 21st or 22nd, I'll link it below, there's going to be an exhibition here called Wings of Riga, and it's the biggest art fair in Latvia. I'm definitely going to be here, make some footage for you guys, because I love this building. But if anybody's interested to visit, or any, you know, artists out there want to exhibit, I'll put you in contact with this nice fella, Sergei. And yeah, what a treat, what a day, what a magnificent day once again. Anyway guys, I hope you like this very short video, and remember, enjoy your journey.